If you follow today's tutorial, you'll learn how to add texture to your flat illustration in just a few steps using Adobe Illustrator. You can download the sketch and the color scheme from the description of this video. My name is Cosmin and I'll walk you through the entire design process. I already have the exercise file open up on my screen and now I can start going to the first step, which is actually tracing all of these outlines. We're going to use an empty fill and an outline stroke to actually trace all of these and create the first layer of this flat illustration. For the outline, we'll actually use this color, the brown here. Let me right click and ungroup it, and with it selected, then you can switch to the pen tool, which is over here, and then start tracing. I'll start with this first shape because it's the easiest one, and once I deselected, I can see it below that it's quite thin. Let's try to get a larger stroke size, maybe 10 points. Choose the brown color, an empty fill, and now that I have this established, it's going to be much easier to actually trace everything. Make sure to have a rounded corner joint and a rounded gap from the stroke panel on the right hand side. From then on out, the process is pretty straightforward. You just take the pen tool and try your best to actually trace this illustration. Whenever you want to see how it actually looks, from the layers panel you can toggle visibility of the sketch, and that will give you a better indication of how it actually looks, because the sketch has a lower transparency so you can see through it. This week's illustrations theme is actually sleeping, because I didn't get a lot of sleep this week. It was kind of one of those weeks where I had a really bad time trying to fall asleep. I was waking up in the middle of the night a couple of times every night, so it was kind of hard to deal with that. So I said that what better way to fix my sleeping issues than create an illustration in Illustrator. As always, feel free to create something different than what you have in the actual sketch. That way you can put your own spin to it, your own style to these types of illustrations, instead of trying to figure out how I'm doing things. If you're wondering what this is actually an earplug. I've tried sleeping with it and this is actually helping me sleep better. If you haven't tried it yet, I do recommend it, but the way the illustration character is using it is not the correct way. You have to have it inside. It shouldn't pop up. Also, whenever you want to have some rounded corners, again switch to the direct selection tool, that's A on the keyboard, click once on the corner if it's straight, and then drag on the handle to actually make it more rounded. For example, it's way easier to just drag on this one and have a really smooth curve instead of trying to get this curve with the pen tool. What you're looking right here are not sunglasses. I was trying to have like a face mask on top because I'm planning to have this illustration be pretty light. That's why I wanted the character to actually have a face mask. Let's take a look and actually see what we got so far. I do need to make a couple of adjustments. Now, we don't really need the sketch anymore. First adjustment is to actually have this tank top go on top. So we don't need this line. But with it selected, switch to the pen tool, add the point on the left-hand side, in the middle, and on the right-hand side. And with the direct selection tool, I'll actually select this one and remove it. Now you're going to see these types of overlaps. So just use the direct selection tool to move it behind. One thing I'll do is actually round off some of the straight corners, but just a bit, a very small radius. For example, for the tank top over here, I'll do a very small adjustment. And now you should be ready to add some color to your actual illustration. With the whole thing selected, I'll make a whole selection to get all of the paths that make out the stroke outline. Hit Command G to actually group it. And now we can start adding colors behind it. Toggle the lock for this one so I can't accidentally hit it, and start creating shapes using this color scheme. I'll start with the lighter shade of blue. Take the pen tool, start from the pillow is actually going to be blue, have it behind the actual outline so I can see how it looks. For the face mask, we'll make it blue as well. Move it behind if you want to see what's happening instead of trying to figure out where the next point needs to go. We're going to use this light pink for the face and the hand. For the nail, I'm actually going to make an adjustment and have it like this because I want the nail to be transparent. For the background, I'll use the light yellow and start creating a shape that goes behind everything. Close it off and then right click on it and arrange and send it to the back. For the hair, I'm guessing it's going to be white just because my hair is turning white since I haven't got any proper sleep for a couple of weeks. I have no idea how to actually place it behind the outlines automatically. If you have any tips, let me know in the comment section of this video. It's going to help me a lot instead of having to manually readjust each time. I'll use Command left bracket to actually send it behind. The plug actually needs to stand out more, so I'm actually going to use the same color. This yellow to create a shape that fills that in. This is the bare minimum of what you can work with. You can actually place grain on it on this version as well, but I want to go one step deeper and actually add some shadows to it. I've already established some darker shades, so I'm going to try to figure out how I can place shadows for this illustration. I'll start with the pillow, so hit Command C, Command F to paste in front. I'll use the curvature tool, start from over here and try to figure out the best way to create a shape. I'll select this and while holding down shift key, I'll select the other one below it. With the shape builder tool, hold down the option key or alt and actually remove the excess parts. And now I'll switch to the eyedropper tool, which is I, and sample the darker shade. Now that I look at it, this is a bit too strong of a shade. So what I want to do is actually have some kind of fading effect. So for that, I'll create a gradient. Let's hit it here and I'll select the left side and actually sample the light shade, and the right side, I'll actually sample the darker shade. And that's going to give me a gradient, which is way easier to work with and have a smoother gradation. Let's do the same for the face mask, copy and paste in front, and then using the pen tool, I'm going to try to figure out, let's say that the light is coming from over here. So the shadows would be in these positions. This would be the first one. While holding down shift, I'll make a selection. With the shape builder tool, hold down the alt key or the option key on a Mac and remove anything that's in excess. I'll sample now this gradient, and this would make it easier to actually work with it and move it behind. For the face, I'm actually trying to do something a bit different and actually have new paths as shadows. So I'm going to shade this part, select the gradient, but we need to select new colors. So with each end, I'm going to sample the color that I actually want here. Let's send it behind and see how this looks. For the hand, I'm actually going to start behind the nail because I want the nail to stand out. Make a couple of straight paths and I'm going to use those and round them up to actually create a more interesting effect. This effect will look well if it's applied to the bottom lip as well. For the background, one thing you can do is again, make a copy out of this and take the pencil tool, double click on it, make sure it's super smooth, and then create an arch. Make sure to close it off. But now it's time to create what you're here for, the actual applying of texture on a flat illustration. I'm going to start with the background. I'll make a copy of the shape, bring it to the front, and then place it on top of this actual shape that's the shadow. From the gradient tab, make sure to select the black and white gradient. And from the effect panel over here, go to texture and hit grain. That'll give you a couple of options. So this is the option grain. Make sure that you have the grain type selected. I usually use stipple just because it has that fine transition. For the background, I like to use something different. Actually go with a vertical one. Hit OK. And now you can see it applied to that actual shape. From the transparency tab, let's go to overlay just because I want increased contrast and lower it to somewhere around 80%. And once you hit G, you can actually make changes to it and this texture will be applied, making it easier to work with it. For the body, select the shape, Command C, Command F to actually bring it to the front, and I'll hit these keys a couple of times till it overlaps with the shadow part, and then do the same thing first. Create a gradient that's black and white, go to effect, texture, grain, and from here actually have stippled selected so you can play around with the intensity. I would like to have a smooth transition, so less contrast. If you have more contrast, then the transition is going to be a bit smaller in width, but I want to have texture applied on almost every part of the illustration. So hit OK. With it selected, go to the transparency tab and let's see how the screen overlay would look like. Now there's a lot of white spots, but the good thing is that once you switch to the gradient tool, you can actually play with it. So you have a lot of control over what you can do with it. Now I'm going to try to create the same effect for all of these three. So with them selected, Command C, Command F, try to bring them to the front. And if you want a shortcut, use the eyedropper tool to actually sample what was before. And it's actually going to take the transparency, set it to screen and have the gradient as well. Now go to effect, hit apply grain, and you already have grain here. Switch to the gradient tool and start making changes just to see how this would look like. The hair stands out a bit just because it's just white. I'm going to actually select a different color. Let's have a hue of this yellow. And we do need to add some kind of texture to it. So Command F to paste it in. Let's sample this gradient and apply some grain to it. It's super fine, you can barely notice it, but it's better than what it used to be. One thing that I'm noticing now that I've added texture is that the line is way too smooth. In the exercise files, I actually got a surprise for you. I added the texture brush, that is a bonus. Go ahead and actually toggle the lock from the outline, select it from the brush panel, apply either the charcoal one or this texture brush. As you can see right now, this is way too much. And you can actually make it 0.07 points to actually look nice. And one nice thing about all of these techniques is that you can actually make changes to them so they're non-destructive. From the appearance panel over here, you can actually go and double click on the grain option. And if you want to switch it out with stipple, you can definitely do that. Let's lower the contrast, and now you have this gradient to work with. This is the final look of the illustration. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you had as much fun as I had. Don't forget to like this video so more people could see it, and subscribe for more. See you in the next one. Take care, everybody. Bye.